The source of Sydney's COVID-19 outbreak has been exposed. A Melbourne man brought the virus across the border to the Crossroads Hotel at Casula. 32 people are now infected. And tonight the Premier is warning of a further tightening of restrictions as the Southwest Cluster forces the closure of more pubs, restaurants and a PCYC at Revesby.
Ground zero for an explosion of coronavirus cases in New South Wales, and today we learned a man from Melbourne most likely lit the fuse.
A man from Melbourne came into a workplace in Sydney, and then there was some transmission within that workplace, and then they all went to a party that night of the 3rd of July at the Crossroads Hotel. This is where it all began.
Jenny Musto is the state's chief virus detective. In recent years, she's been on the case in war-torn Yemen and Bangladesh. The mission here, to flush out patient zero.
The man from Melbourne didn't think he was particularly unwell, didn't think he was sick with COVID.
His identity hasn't been revealed, but he works at a Wetherill Park freight company and is not a truck driver. He set off on his ill-fated journey from Victoria on June 30 and immediately became a super spreader, infecting six Sydney colleagues before they all headed to the Crossroads Hotel.
We've identified all links at this point in time, but we'll get new cases and we'll have to identify further links with them.
13 new cases today of COVID and 10 of those linked with the Crossroads, 32 now in total. The race is on to track down and trace the movements of confirmed cases, from a pub in Picton to a burger joint in Parramatta and plenty of places in between. New to the list, the MacArthur Tavern at Campbelltown, West Leagues Club at Lamia, Woolworths at Barrel, a pizza restaurant at Belfield and the YMCA at Revesby. The Premier today was at lunch talking up the economy and talking down any hope of eliminating the virus.
I think suppression is our only option.
Will you consider further restrictions in coming days?
Oh, I think we have to consider further restrictions. Any activity which is high risk.
Yesterday it was pubs cutting back on the number of patrons. Now Nine News understands weddings and funerals could be next, reducing the numbers by making changes to the 4 square metre rule. In the meantime, the drive to get tested has moved up a gear.
We were in a queue yesterday for about 4 hours and missed out, so we thought we'd get in early today.
Demand had caused long delays, so new testing clinics are popping up in the southwest.
We came in contact with someone that's tested positive recently. No, you're not worried, you're just going to do what you're going to do.
Queensland continues to be a no-go zone for people living or having visited Sydney's hotspots. Yesterday, this man and his son rolled the dice but lost, turned around at Proserpine, and they were back in Sydney this morning.
It was just pretty much pay for a flight home or pay for quarantine. Flight back's a lot cheaper than quarantine.
The Northern Territory has also decided to put up the wall.
We will declare all 30 local government areas in Greater Metropolitan Sydney as hotspot areas for the purposes of travel to the Northern Territory.
Even the RSL in Bathurst has declared residents from Sydney and the Blue Mountains are not welcome.
Our main priority in this is to keep our doors open, and the best way that we can do that, we think, is by looking after our community and surrounding areas.
Damien Ryan, Nine News.
OK, let's go to Nine's Grace Fitzgibbon, who's at Wetherill Park this evening. Grace, businesses in the area are taking no chances.
That's right, Pete. This trucking company behind me is certainly taking all precautions. They've put up signs to say the office will be closed until tomorrow because it needs to be thoroughly cleaned. And we understand that's because one woman who works in reception here came into contact with a positive case. And while she has returned a negative result, it goes to show how seriously they're taking things. Tonight, Pete, this is the level of concern.
All right, Grace, thank you. Let's go from Wetherill Park live to Elizabeth Bryan at Brighton Le Sands, where Hurricane's Grill, a well-known restaurant, has also been caught up in a COVID scare. Lizzie, what information do you have for us?
Well, Pete, of course, the focus has been on our southwest, but it seems as though this flare-up is heading closer to the city. Last Saturday night, a person with coronavirus has had dinner here at the popular Hurricanes Bar and Grill between the times of 6 and 8pm. The scramble is now very much on to try and track down potentially dozens of people who've come into contact with this individual as the restaurant undergoes deep cleaning until Friday. Pete, if people were here at this time and are experiencing any symptoms, they're being urged to get tested tested immediately.
Elizabeth, thank you. Chris O'Keefe's with me in the studio. Chris, do we have these outbreaks under control here in Sydney?
We're going okay, Peter. The doctors were certainly expecting the numbers to be worse from the Casula outbreak than they are. The caseload here in Sydney is still very, very small. And while Gladys Berejiklian is likely to restrict the number of people allowed at funerals, weddings and visitors at your home, we are not talking about a shutdown. The Premier will not touch business unless it gets to a critical point. People's mental health and jobs are just too important at this point. It's chalk and cheese in comparison to what's happening in Melbourne. Dozens of nursing homes have infections inside, and harsher lockdowns there could be on the way.
The source of the Sydney spike: consistent breaches in Melbourne's hotel quarantine, and Daniel Andrews is being blamed for allowing it to happen.
We know the second wave in Australia was certainly made in Melbourne, and it's a man-made disaster. It's a Dan-made disaster now for our country.
Regardless of the bungle, cases of the virus have not just escaped quarantine, they've jumped our southern border. And the Crossroads cluster is unlikely to be the lone outbreak here.
What we do know is that the strain genetically that's turned up in New South Wales has come from Victoria. We do know that.
The situation in Melbourne is dire. 3 dead in 24 hours, 238 more people COVID positive, notching up a 9-day streak of more than 100 cases. The second wave looking like a block of skyscrapers, dwarfing what we saw in April.
We are in as Victorians. We are in as Melburnians. The great fight of our lives.
And nowhere is that statement more literal than the 108 cases in 32 Victorian nursing homes infiltrated by coronavirus.
An email last night to say there was another 3 cases had been detected in here.
Graham Smith's home has a dozen cases. His neighbour, 90-year-old great-grandfather Alf Jordan, was one and didn't survive.
Yeah, a little scared. It brings it very close to home. I live not far from where I am. And, it was a bit of a shock.
The Defence Force flew in an additional 100 soldiers, healthcare workers gearing up too, for what they hoped would never come.
I would hope that it's turning the corner this week, but no guarantees.
Daniel Andrews is threatening a harder lockdown, closing more businesses and preventing movement.
If, however, people do not do the right thing, then we will have to move to additional restrictions being put in place.
Melburnians are losing their daily freedoms, and now they've lost their famous pastime. The AFL has declared it's likely they will not play another game in Victoria for the rest of the season.
Victorian teams will be based out of Queensland for up to 10 weeks.
The grand final hasn't been held outside of Melbourne in 122 years. It's looking shaky, but not a write-off yet.
There is no decision made on the grand final. This is about the home and away season.
All of our leaders say eradication is not possible. Another countrywide lockdown would see unemployment double. Managing the virus is the only way, but the methods aren't foolproof.
As the health minister here, I'm very conscious of the fact that there, but for the grace of God, goes everybody here in Australia.
Chris O'Keefe, Nine News.
An inquiry into the Ruby Princess has heard the cruise ship should not have been allowed to dock until the results of COVID-19 test swabs were received. In making final submissions, council assisting the inquiry said classifying ships as low, medium or high risk was meaningless when it came to a disease such as COVID-19.
The assumption is, as soon as you get a confirmed result, you are all suspect cases of COVID. You all come off the ship or you are going to quarantine.
While more than a dozen swabs for COVID-19 were taken and sent to a lab for testing, passengers were allowed to disembark before results came back. More than 20 deaths have been linked to the ship. The commissioner will hand down his report next month.